Welcome back everybody. This is the continuation of the last video. So if you haven't checked it out, I suggest you do that first. We are looking at basic test validation of a GET API call. So let's continue. We will hold on to this scenario for a bit. Let me just comment this out. And let me first show you a scenario where we could use query parameters and request headers, and then we will come back to the scenario. Let me just copy paste the scenario again. Let's dash works with query parameter. So if you look at this post returns all the 100 posts posted by all the users, but let's say I wanted to look at only the posts posted by user ID 1. In this case, I think all it will return is just do it raw. You know, you have is there are 10 posts which are posted by user ID 1. Let's say, how would I test if I wanted to test this, right? Because user ID here is a query parameter. Query parameter is a something that follows after a question mark, and it's in the form of key value pair. So in here, user ID is the key and one is the value. And if I were to do that, all of these things remain the same, except before sending the GET request, I have to say that I will be using a query parameter, and the key in this case would be user ID and the value would be 1, right? So if I do this, it is the same post path, but on top of it, now I'm filtering it through the query parameters, and it should only return, let's say, we just saw that it returns an array of 10 objects. So let me also do that assertion here. Let's say we say it should return 10 objects, and there we go. So this is how you would use a query parameter in the request. What about let's say you wanted to send a request to send a special header in the request itself. In the earlier example, we saw how to validate a response header, but if you look at over here, these are some of the headers which are set in the request. What if we wanted to set our own custom header? The way to do that would be, you would say again, before GET, you would say, I also want to set a header. Let's say I say X transaction ID, and you can give any value. Say I call this 1, 2, 3, 4, and if I run this now, you see you have now set a custom header in the request itself, and if the backend code is expecting this or is supposed to work on this, it could do that now. So this is how you would set your request headers. All right, coming back to the earlier scenario that we put on hold. So now you know that doing this, you could only do you can only fetch post with ID as 1, but this needs to be dynamic, right? You don't always need it to be 1. So one way to get there is to define a variable, and so one way could be, you can say, you can move this to end and say define a variable, and this is how you would define a variable. You'd say let's say UID equal to 1, and then so what you would do here is you would remove 1 from here because you don't want to hard code the value in the path, but you want to use the variable instead, and then you can say end path as UID. So what this would do is it would take the URL, the base URL first, then it would go and see that there is a path called as post. So it would append slash post to this base URL, and then it will see a path again, and then it will append slash UID. It would find out that UID is a variable whose value is one. So it would essentially treat this as post slash one, affecting the same thing. So this ID, you're still sort of limited to testing post ID as one, but as we will see, we'll see in future lessons how we could make this variable receive different values. But for now, all we are doing here is, instead of hard coding it one in the path itself, it is taking a variable, and rest everything remains the same. Let's just check this out quickly, and it works. All right, now let's also test. If you run this, you run this particular code, you see that it's not an array anymore, it's a JSON object, and we have verified that the status is 200. But what if we wanted to not only verify the status was 200, but we also wanted to validate the actual response, right? So in this case, so the quickest thing that you could do, of course, is you can say and, again use the match keyword. We know the response is present in the response object, so you could do response equal to, and then use three quotation marks is basically to allow you to write multi-line statements. So in this case, what you could do is you could say verify that the response is as such, because you know this is not going to be changing if it is only for post one, unless you make any put or delete operation. In this case, your response should match the expected response, and it does. But this is not very useful, right? Because tomorrow you would want to do this for post one. Oh, sorry, I think this shouldn't have been a UID. Maybe I should call it a post ID, because it is not a user ID really, it's a post ID. Nonetheless, it doesn't change anything, it's just a variable name that I've changed to make it consistent with what the API actually does. Coming back to the point, so this is not the best way of validating a response, because you wouldn't know a response in every case, and the title would vary, the body would vary. What you know for sure in this case is title is certain string, a body is certain string, user ID is certain number, and this ID is the post ID that you originally requested, that is one. So it is not only that it is a number, but it is a specific number that you requested for. So one way you could test this is, and if you look at karate, if you look at, there are some markers that karate gives you, let's say this is an array. These are the markers that you can see. You could use these markers to validate whether the expected value is a string, expected value is a number, expected value is an array. So we are going to be using this. In this case, we know that user ID is going to be a number, so we can say so. We know that title is going to be a string, we can say that. We also know that body is going to be another string. I'll just remove this, I'll just copy this, put it over here, and in this case this is also a number. So let's quickly run this, and this should also pass, right? Just to make sure that it really asserts in the right possible manner. Let's just change this to a string. We are saying that we expect this user ID to be a string, whereas we know that it's a number, so our assertion should fail, right? And it says Yeah, could not match user ID because what you got is not a string, but you got a number as expected. So let's change it back. Now, what you also know is that this ID is the post ID that we requested for. It's not just that it is a number, but it is this specific number, right? And you already have it in a variable, and you could use that variable in the assertions also. And the way to do that is just use it in brackets, just like that. The quotes and hash marks still remains, and you could just use this variable over here. So all you're saying is ID should exactly match the post ID that we requested for, and there you go. Just like number and string markers, you also saw that there is an array marker. We could go back to our first test, and we can see here that we expect the response to be array, right? We can see that it should be an array, and there should be a match keyword before this. Now if you run this, you know, the test is passed. What else can you do? Because this is an array, and let me go back to that array again. Because this is an array, let's say we wanted to assert on the first object on that array, right? And what we can do here is, instead of saying, or on top of saying that a response should be an array, we want to validate that the first response, the first object in that array, it's a zeroth object in that array, should match, you know. And we can copy paste the same assertion over here. I think you can also write it in one statement. Paste this over here. If you keep it in one line, you don't need those three quotation marks. And so basically what it says, and there is no post ID here, so I'll just say it's a number. And that is it. I think if I run this, it still passes, right? What else can you do? Of course, if you knew that the first response was always from a user ID 1, you could also, you know, put 1 over here. That should also work. What if you did not know that this was the first object, but you wanted to verify that it is present somewhere in the response? The way to handle that would be match response, and you would say match anywhere in the array, and make sure in this case, now you wouldn't do equal to, because equal to is for exact match. In the first case, it would match this exactly, the first element, or in the post case, this would match it exactly. If the response contained any other key on top of this, it would have failed. So in this case, you can't use equal to, because the response altogether is a collection of 100 objects. So in our case though, we want to verify that this particular object exists, for which we will use contains. And now I could use the same thing. I could also, if for instance, if I knew that the ID, the post ID was also 1, I could also use that, and if I ran this, it should pass, right? Whereas if I just did equal to, it should fail, because you're now saying the whole of response should be this, which it is not. The whole of response is 100 different object, and this is just one of the object in there, right? So if I just undo this, and same is the case here, right? In the first scenario, if I just remove the body, right, and I try to assert this with equal to, it would fail because the actual response contained body, and in the assertion I did not have body, so it would fail. But whereas if I use contains, it would pass. Right? All right, that is it. And but what if you really wanted to assert on each of the object in that array? In that case, what you could do is you could use and match each of the object in the response, right? And you wouldn't know the whole object as is, but you know the schema, in which case you could say, you know, I want each of the response object to follow this schema. That is, the UID should be a number, the ID should be a number, a title should be a string, and body should be a string. You could use equal to now because you're using all the keys present in that object. And for each of those object in that array, you are validating the schema. And if you run this, even this should successfully. All right, that is it. I think we have covered a lot of ground here. This should set you up to test, I'd say, you know, almost 40 to 50% of your cases, because most of the time you'd want to test get. We will also cover post, put, and delete in future lessons. But I think that is it for now. Thank you.